weekendy. Weekendy basically, I didn't plan. We had to take time out, you know, review Rema's dressers and everyone who came to visit, listen to all the speeches. It was a long weekend, if you ask me, but not for me. I was in my bed asleep, just doing me. Yeah. But I hope you had yourselves a good one. My name is Cinefierce One. It's Monday. Yay, we're all excited. Let's get it. I sit it with Wait, Josephine, we forgot to address my hair situation before they all come jumping into the comment section. We shouldn't? We don't have time for that. I don't owe anybody an explanation for all this fineness, okay. I was seated with a couple of friends, as usual, to better truly call a review, hashtag Lugambo. And we were wondering, because I was going through Zari's different social media platforms. Now, y'all remember there was a time when King Bear was the hashtag on all her posts. She would probably take a photo taking a dump and she's like, hashtag King Bear. And then, before we know it, there is no King Bear. Before we know it, the hashtag stopped. Before we know it, I hear your banging grenade. I just had to drop that one like that. Boom. So apparently, those in the know, chembadenga mbabanta wali wanum studio, mbabuzi zavanae, someone needs to find out what Grenade has in his pants. Ali namuchi. As in a masakaje ya kulida. Obama mwakati. Nga kukubako bwati no gobele. Atechila. Grenade started sleeping with women older than him at the age of about 15. So he is 20 what? 21 now? I need to know. Don't you? Josephine, don't you want to know? Why is all these old women getting their knickers in a twist over him? Like, I need to understand why every woman who has hit pretty much, what's it called, menopause, is looking for you, Grenade. Like, and those are usually the insatiable ones, so. What do you have in your pants, Grenade? I'm just saying, I mean, watu yimbira kayimba not tera uka sample, jatuloga, masakanchi manji mulibalugo nae. What does this boy have in his pants? So rumor has it, as much as you're seeing him with AK-47's widow, that's of course Nalongo. Apparently, Nezari abada uba uba. I do not know how true this is. But coming from the sources that gave it to me. I know Zari hasn't made any rounds on Scoop in a while, you know? I think we all got tired of her faking it. But if it's true, anyway, you know what? Who cares? Their cookies, their bodies. Do you, it's 2019. I ain't finna waste time on nobody's sexual habits. I just want Grenade to tell me. I mean, if you can holler at a sister, just holler and let me know what you got in them pants. What? Not that I want to see it firsthand, but okay, if Grenade cannot tell me what he has in his pants, but now whoever has banged this caffeine, explain to us and 50 million others, what does this boy have in his pants? Kwesiga lipstick. Actually, me, I believe, you know when people are calling Eddie Kenzo the love nigger, and you know that the president Love Niggers Association never semi okozo. I believe the very first person who was supposed to be called the love nigger hashtag Semi Okozo is Wyke Bender. What do I'm seeing? Okay, Babidi, Wyke Bender and Bruno K. Wyke Bender wears so much lip gloss. There's a time I thought probably he has like a contract with a lip gloss company. Dang. As for the other one, Bruno K. Let's just say the only words that come up to my mind when someone mentions the name Bruno K is the color pink. And not the bright one. Baby pink. Just say. Anyway. So why? Namunde kandi namko. Priya kampale ntamye. Temunchampa motivation ni. Aba imbi tebachayo no na. But now they are trying to keep their images together. Because they all think that because Bobby Wine made it to parliament, now they are all going to join politics. There is another life to lead. Mbadde njogera kwani? Waiki Benda. Yeah, Waiki Benda says he's still single. Isn't this the guy who just had a baby boy? So wait, that was a bang and go situation? Nikakwatirayo, newavayo mwana. Because I was looking at his Facebook performance and something was dropped around there like, oh, I'm free, I'm single. I'm even bored just running these stories. Maybe you guys should start giving me stories. I can't deal with this shit. There's this story that has been making rounds about a baby who lost an entire arm due to negligence of the hospital because they gave them interns to perform an emergency C-section, and apparently as that was going on, the baby has a severed arm off, blah, blah, blah. The story made so much noise on social media. I first saw it on Twitter, I went to Facebook, it was there. It was all over the place. And I was trying to understand how possible is that in just simple logical terms. So I went and tried to find out what I could. Now they said, the interns say, yes, it was a confusing situation. Case in point is, I know you've seen the story of a baby who has a severed arm. My thing though is, after everybody ran with that story, someone goes on a different timeline and says, yo, look here, my name is so-and-so and I work at Ginger Hospital. None of this happened. That baby was just born with a problem with their hand and the orthopedic had to actually authorize them to cut off that hand. So, after she said that, I'm like, wait. We were all getting very emotional and pissed off. It became so political. And it goes back to what Donald Trump always says. It's just fake news, just fake news. Because if someone can throw a story like that, nach sindikayo, mwenane muyimirira, mwenane munyiga, mwenane musasamala, mwenane muita out different people. So how, it makes me think about all the other stories that are online. What if all those stories are actually false? What if all those stories, it's just propaganda? Yes, I know the stories that are actually birthed out of propaganda just to get people confused. But do you know why they birthed those stories in the first place? Because they know you're going to get confused. Because you religiously believe in anything you find on the internet, which sucks. This is the edge of millennials, man. If it's on the internet, it's true. Have you tried Google searching a disease you have? Keeps like about 50 other diseases. You know, the reason I was talking about that story is I think we can't take away social media, but I think as people, as individuals, we need to learn how to discern. We need to understand, I can pledge my allegiance not based on what I've seen on social media, but what I know for fact. Times I wish I could go back to the 90s. The 90s were fun. I just chanced upon, Josephine, have you seen that list of the parties that are going to be in Kampala? From the 21st of November to what day? The beginning of next year. Look at you playing pretend like you don't know. I know, I saw that list of all the parties in Kampala. And I'm like, wait, why do the youth keep saying we are suffering? Why do the youth keep saying we are unemployed when they can afford to keep promoters that busy? I mean, we have Wizkid coming down. We have Maya. Maya is about to do her thing. We have Coffee. Yes, Coffee. Rapture, that chick. Apparently, she's coming too. We have P-Square. He's coming too. We have John Black's concert. It's going to be there. There's going to be like about 5 concerts. Like, who are these people? And what's funny is they fill up. I thought that whole Nyege Nyege week was going to be balanced, but no. Everybody showed up. Everybody went to a different party and they all made money. So why do we keep saying we are struggling as a nation? I'm just asking. I know all of you are going to get pissed off and go like, T, the reason why we party so much or drink so much is because this nation is messed up and the government and police and government. I'm just tired of that bullcrap. If you want to go and have fun, go have fun and don't blame it on anyone or anything. On that note, it's going to be a very late November to December, so. Where was I? The party life. Ah, this Monday sucks. I think tomorrow I'll get back my groove. As for now, the weekend didn't have much to offer. Rema is still on Twitter, telling us she loves Hamza. We do what? Tukabe! Surama bere mchoto, we are done. We saw the electrical dress, we saw it all, the party. We are never aware that. Tuleke mutulo kalide fumba. Who else? Where are other musicians quiet? Bebe kulta nakula chabsiru. Chameleon, it's like he doesn't even live in this country anymore. All I'm saying is boring. I'm bored. At @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and @TinaFierce1. On Instagram, @TinaFierce1 with an H, and on Snapchat, @TinaFierce1. Let's hope I got you tomorrow if I have stories. I'm out. Peace.